seen heaven invades the earth. So just begin to lift up your hallelujah. Raise it like a banner. Raise it like a flag. Raise it in the middle of the storm. Let it rise. Let it rise. Like a symphony to the King. Everything to you, Jesus. We raise it all up. Thank you.
me a second. There we go. Okay, I'm on. I'm live. How you like that, Kaysen?
I don't know.
Kaysen is here because today's not just any Sunday. It's
Youth Sunday.
We are so excited. For those of you who don't know, Youth Sunday is the first Sunday of every month here. And it's a time where we do an interactive sermon. We have all the teens and young adults in here. And we have a message that's interactive and fun, but it is just as good for adults. So that being said, I again want to welcome all of you here. If this is your first time here, we want you to know that you are loved and you are welcome just the way that you are. If you don't know me, my name is CJ Malmcar, and I'm the Love Avenue champion, as well as one of the pastors right here at GC Surrey Hills.
And my name is Kaysen Malmcar, and I serve here in
GC Surrey Kids.
And we are just so thankful that you're here. I do want to just give a little kind of pointer. We want you to know that we are a praying church. So if you have any prayers that you are needing, later on in the service, after the sermon, during our time of giving, there's going to be a basket passed around. If you have any prayers that you want the pastors to be praying for you over, only the pastors will see it. You can put those prayers on that connection card, fold it in half, and place it in the basket as they go around, and we will be praying for you completely confidentially. We love you guys so much, and we just wanted you to know that. All right, are we ready to worship? All right, let's get started.
Good morning. Would you please stand and join us as we worship the Lord, the King of Kings, the Holy of Holies.
Your praise.
Lift him up and give him praise this morning.
There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need you've got. There's honey in the rock. Only you can satisfy. There's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock.
Yeah.
Freedom
where the spirit is,
bounty
in the wilderness.
In the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need you've got. There's honey in the rock, purpose in your plan, power in the blood, healing in your hands, starting flowing when you said it is done. Everything you did is easy. Keep looking, I keep finding, you keep giving, keep providing, I have all that I need, you are all that I need. I keep praying, you keep moving, I keep praising, you keep proving, I have all that I need, you are all that I need. I keep looking, I keep finding, you keep giving, keep providing, I have all that I need, you are all that I need. I keep praying, you keep moving, I keep praising, you keep proving. On the ground, no matter where I go, I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need you've got. There's honey in the rock, purpose in your plan, power in the blood, healing in your hands, starting flowing when you said it is done. Jesus, who you are is enough. There's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock. Oh, how sweet it is to trust in you, Jesus. Oh, how sweet it is to trust in you, Jesus. Oh, how sweet. How sweet it is to trust in you, Jesus.
It It's okay. We can go ahead and we give him praise. We're going to slow it down a little bit. You know, we just came out of Easter, and this is a good reminder, even after Easter, of what Jesus gave, which is everything. He put his love on the line.
Washing
We thank you for all that you gave for sinners like us. Thank you for saving us with your grace, your and your love, and your mercy. Amen.
With all that we are, we stand in his grace. Amen. Well, good morning, church family. It is so good to see you all. And welcome to those of you who are joining us online. We're so glad you're with us as well. If, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Mike Rasmussen, and I am first and foremost a beloved child of God, just as you are. But I also have the privilege of serving as one of the pastors here at GC Surrey Hills, and I would like to welcome you. If this is your first time here, we're so glad you're here. We pray that you will understand the love of God and that you are loved not only by God, but by us, just where you are. We mean that with our hearts. I'd also like to say that we are not a church that is built on a set of rules and regulations, but we are a church that is built on a deep abiding relationship with one person, and that one person is with Jesus Christ. And out of that relationship, we learn how to love one another, how to help one another, and how to serve our neighborhood. And so I wanted to say that at this congregation, we have a saying. And we always start our service with this saying, and it is our very first core value. These are our core values around the wall. But we always start with Jesus, period. That's where it all begins. If we start anywhere else, we're already off track. It has to start with Jesus, looking through the lens, through the love of Jesus Christ. Today is kind of an unusual day for us because we only do it once a month, but today is Youth Sunday. We really value our young people. We believe they're not only our future, but they are our present. And we want to pour into them and also meet them where they are. So I hope that even though this is geared to our young people, that all of us will take something home from this message today. Let us pray. Father, we come before you so thankful for how you work in our lives, that by the Holy Spirit, Lord, you change us. You change how we think, how we see things, how we feel about you and feel about others, and how we love as you have loved us. And so, Lord, we just thank you, and we ask that as we talk about you and talk about things of you, whether it be in a sermon or worship or in our conversations, that your name may be glorified. We ask all of this in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. All right. I want to start today. If I can get the young people, come up, sit up front. If you older people can switch back to the back behind them, if you would. All right, I want to read you guys a story, and I want you to listen very carefully because your very life may depend on it. Okay? The day has arrived. The day has arrived. You are finally 18 years old. You graduated last week from high school. You and your best friend that you've been saving and planning all year long to go to Colorado for an epic hiking expedition. You have carefully packed your backpack, considering every detail. You even got your car checked by a mechanic for the long drive. You have left detailed instructions as good young adults with your parents and friends, explaining the exact trail you will be hiking just in case something happens. After 2 days of driving, you arrive at the base of the Rockies. It's gorgeous. The mountain peaks seem to never end. Filled with excitement, you stop at the ranger station like a wise young adult to get updates on weather and hiking conditions. You find out from the ranger that there has been a mudslide on the trail that you had hoped to hike. The ranger suggests another couple trails to consider and informs you, due to the road repairs from the mudslide, you will need to leave your car in town and take the shuttle bus that makes stops at all the various trail entrances. You load your gear up in your backpack. You and your friends have planned extremely well. You have brought plenty of water, food, listen carefully, extra clothes, sleeping bags, a two-person tent, first aid kit, your cell phone, and even a small solar charger to keep your cell phone charged. Brilliant, guys. Well done. The day is perfect, and the weather is gorgeous. Halfway up the trail, you stop by a running river to have lunch together. It is amazing. There are no other hikers. It's like you have the whole mountain to yourself. After lunch, you head up the trail a little further. The trail begins to narrow. You now have a steep mountain wall on your right side and a steep drop-off on your left side, which ends down by the river. A couple hours later, you both get a weird feeling. You can't put your finger on it, but something isn't right. Then suddenly you understand why. You see a large black bear just ahead on the trail. It's no more than 40 feet away. You cannot walk past the bear, and you can't go backwards because your friend's behind you. You are trapped between your friend and this bear. Then, as if things couldn't get worse, you see the bear is a mama bear with two small cubs. Your friend panics and runs back down the trail, leaving you by yourself. You've heard on TikTok it's not wise to show fear or run from a black bear, especially one that is protecting her cubs. You slowly take off your backpack and hold it in front of you, between you and the bear. You begin to slowly walk backwards. At least if the bear comes forward, you can have your backpack to protect you, or if necessary, to throw at her. She continues to walk towards you, making a loud growling noise. Your heart pounds inside your chest, and you begin to back up very slowly. While trying to stay calm as possible, not an easy thing to do, now the bear is 5 feet away. She takes a lunge and swipes at you. She misses you, but her front claw sinks deeply into your backpack. You continue to back up and are thankful she has taken an interest in the food that's in your backpack, allowing you to continue to back up. Suddenly, you lose your footing and you begin to slide down the mountain the whole way down, and it ends at the river. You begin to tumble head over heel, coming to a sudden stop right next to the river. You try to sit up, but realize you have badly injured your ankle. It may even be broken. The good news is the side of the mountain appears too steep for the bear to navigate, especially with cubs. The bad news is the river is too swift and rocky to float down, and the bear has your backpack, and there is no sign of your friend. You reach into your pocket to get your cell phone to call for help, and you suddenly remember you put it in your backpack after lunch, along with your wallet and car keys. You have nothing except the clothes on your back. What are you going to do? You're 18. You're an adult. You can make decisions now. Fortunately for you, just like in the Hunger Games, you get to pick three items from this table. And I will give you a bonus item because I went through and tried to figure out what I would take, and I would want four items. You will have 1 minute to look over the items. There'll be a countdown timer up on the front, and we'll help you when it gets, let's not panic them too much. When it gets to five, let's help them count down so they know when to stop.
That helps a lot.
It does. You will have 1 minute to look over the items and write down three items you have chosen. Once you write them down and your time is up, you cannot change your answers. Once everybody has chosen their items, you will have a chance to explain why you chose those three items. Four items. All right, let me give you some advice. In a survival situation, realize there is a rule of threes. You have about 3 minutes without air. Most people can hold their breath for 3 minutes if they have to. You have 3 days without water, and you have 3 weeks without food. You have no idea how long you're going to be there. You cannot crawl away because your ankle is so bad and it's so steep that if you start to move, you will fall into the river. It's cold, and you might get hypothermia and die. It's also very rocky, and the chances are really good you're going to hit your head as you're going down the river. Okay? Are we clear? All right. Who wants to go first? Yeah, if you can help me take it off. All right. Who wants to go first? Look at you. Here's your little pad and a pen, okay. And you can write down your 4 items that you get to choose. If you have questions, you can ask about them. What if you don't know what something is?
Oh, I had a flip phone.
Oh, you had a flip phone. Oh, the timer. Is the timer going? Here we go. Hold on. Go. You can look at them all first before you write if you want. It's up to you. That's a lighter. It's a windproof lighter. Well, you don't want us counting it down the entire time.
I wouldn't mind.
Well, let's count it for her to help her out. Yeah, 25.
That's a canteen.
It is. 20. It is not full of water, but you're next to a river. Oh. And the river is clean.
Okay.
Clean water.
Okay.
10 seconds.
Wait.
Isn't the river 7, 6, 5.
4 items.
3, 2, 1.
Awesome. Take your thing here.
Okay.
You can have it, and I'll take the pen.
I'm old.
Who wants to go next? Boy. Here you go. Here you go. Give them 5 seconds to look at it. If you can get the clock up, ready to go. Give them 5 seconds. Hold on. Go back to the beginning if you would. Here we go. Ready? Mm-hmm. Set. Go. It's freshwater. Freshwater river in Colorado. Yes.
Yeah. Is there fish in this river?
There could be fish in the river.
Okay,
yeah, I don't know.
I
didn't check the river out ahead of time, but... Yeah, yeah. More than likely, at Colorado River, you'd have fish.
Okay, can I ask Roger, do you have a cell phone?
Yes, right here.
Okay.
If you have any questions, ask.
Cell service?
I don't know. I'm not there with you. You're by yourself. Yeah, that's one of the tough things of being an adult, making decisions.
There you
surviving?
Go.
Maybe.
All right, who's next?
Layla, let's go. Let's go, Layla.
Let's go, Layla.
Layla was our winner from last month.
You know you want that toilet paper.
All right, 5 seconds. Ready, set, go. You guys aren't asking a lot of questions about things. It's great that you can identify all these. Nope. Once you're gone, you can ask a question once everybody's gone. Okay. Look at that. Whoa.
She's decisive.
You're either going to live or you're going to die.
Very good.
That's yours.
Oh, I think that.
Next. All right, there's your pen. All right, 5 seconds to look it over. Oh, man, she's already writing. Start the clock.
Stop, Jim.
Are you going to look at the items?
Oh, no, I know.
She's got a photographic memory. She's got these things memorized.
Oh, I had no memorized. I lost it.
You got time. You're good. Yep, 40 seconds left. Awesome. You can take that with you. Very good. All right. Next victim.
Thank you. Come on, Ruben. Go pick. Go show him the box.
There you go. There you go. You got 5 seconds before we start the clock. Let's start the clock. Wow. Very good. You gonna live or die?
Guess we'll find out.
Yeah. Got one left. So I think it falls to you, brother. Give him 5 seconds. Start the clock. Seconds left. Very good. All right. Is that all of our teens?
I'm ready to explain.
All right. Well, good. You're about to get a chance to. If you could turn around and with a microphone there, explain to us all what you picked and why.
We got a phone because you don't need cell service or Wi-Fi to call 911. FYI, everybody. No, you don't. No, because it works. When my phone was on SOS and I didn't have anything, it called 911 still. So, boom.
Any cell phone experts out there that can help us out?
I had a phone that didn't work without Wi-Fi for like 6 months.
We don't have the Rocky Mountains in
Oklahoma. Yeah. Hey!
Signals.
Hey!
Look,
okay,
I've been in Colorado. There's lots of areas you don't get cell service.
Hey, we can throw it out. We can throw that one out. I don't even need that.
Okay.
I can live.
Okay, good, good.
Okay, first aid kit. Your ankle... dead, and you can use a stick, make a splint, okay? I don't need anything for that other than, like, probably the stuff in the first aid kit, a canteen so I can get fresh water, and a net so I can catch fish.
All right, very good.
Phone, first aid kit, canteen, net.
Okay, very good. Who went next? Let's do it in the order that we did it. Come up and face the audience and tell them what you chose.
I may have messed up. First aid kit.
What'd you choose?
I say I may have messed up.
Oh, you may have messed up. Okay.
Yeah. First aid kit.
Okay, first aid kit.
Gotta heal your ankle. A rope. So it's kind of hard, but I would use it to scale down the mountain.
There's no down. You're at the bottom.
You're at the bottom.
At the river. So you'd have to get up. But there's a bear up there.
Then.
And you got a broken ankle.
I would tie the rope to a rock.
Okay.
And then grab, like, the rope and try and swim across the water. That might happen.
Okay.
This rope is pretty long.
Okay.
Cell phone, what Gabby said. Phone charger. Shouldn't have done that.
I'm not surprised that your age bracket thinks the cell phone's going to save you, but that's okay. I get it. It'd be hard sitting down not being able to look at it.
I have a question. Are we allowed to take off?
Change your mind?
Like, take off a cloth.
You take off whatever you want, because you're by yourself up there, hopefully.
So can
you'll find out if someone has cell service, and they can film you, and then it's on TikTok. But yeah.
Can I explain what I was gonna do?
You explain what you can do. Yeah.
I was gonna get the rope, use the first aid kit, and then use a piece of clothing, and tie a piece of clothing above my leg to cut off the circulation for blood not coming out.
That's good. But I didn't say anything about blood coming out. I said it was broken. You tie a tourniquet on, you lose that leg. You realize that. By the time you get rescued, you're going to be one-legged.
Can I change my answer?
You cannot change your answer.
I want the lighter.
Why, are you going to set yourself on fire so that you don't bleed to death? What?
No.
Yes. Carterize it. A lighter. Good luck with that.
I would have used a lighter to burn
okay.
the rope.
No, look. But... Hey, these are tough decisions. It's tough. And I don't know that there's right answers. I mean, I think there's better answers than others, but there's not right answers. You don't know the circumstances. You could be rescued the next day. You could be rescued 6 weeks.
I want the net.
Or never. Well, you should have chosen the net. You had time, I think, didn't you, on the clock?
Yep. Mm. Wait, since everybody's done, I have a question.
No, not everybody's done. Hold on, you can ask your questions, but not everybody's done. Who went next?
Layla.
Layla.
Okay, so I did peanut butter because, you know, food.
Yeah.
Canteen for water.
Yeah.
Axe for building shelter. First aid for ankle.
Axe and first aid. Okay, very good.
How do you build a shelter? You cut down a tree. You have a mountain.
Kaysen, have you ever seen Naked and Afraid? Because that's what you're going to be because you're taking clothes off. And I would be very afraid.
Okay.
All right, go ahead.
Okay. I want everybody to know I'm the one that's surviving.
All right. Confidence, I like it.
I'm taking the first aid kit I could use the wrap to wrap my ankle so that way I can finally move. The knife, since I'm next to the river, I can use it to stab and catch fish to eat. The canteen to get water from the river, and the rope to possibly set up traps on land to catch even more food.
Okay. Woo! All right.
Mic drop.
Very good. Next. What do you mean? What'd you get? What items did you choose? Okay, why would you get a rope? What were you going
to
use it for?
Trying to climb the mountain.
Climb the mountain? Okay. What's the next thing?
Net.
Net, the mosquito net. What would you use that for?
I'm trying to like get it stuck on something so I can climb.
Okay, so, all right. Next item?
Flashlight.
Flashlight, why the flashlight?
In case I get lost when it's dark.
Okay.
And the axe for the bear.
Axe for the bear. Yeah, those work well. Yeah. Good. Good. Nope, after everybody's done. No, you may not. You may come up here. Come on.
Come on. Don't touch me.
You're 18 years old. Come on.
I got an axe. Shelter. And yeah. I got peanut butter for food. I got a canteen for water and a tape for my ankle.
Okay.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah. Duct tape. I thought every guy would choose the duct tape. I mean, that fixes everything, right? All right, questions. Okay.
Is the cell phone dead?
So, did you open it?
No.
You should have opened it.
I didn't know you were allowed to open this.
That thing has been dead for at least 10 years.
Oh, I'm smart! I'm smart, guys!
No.
All right. All right, any other questions? Let's go through some of these items. A rope. That would be great if you knew how far across the river it was and how far you could throw this and get it to stay, right? But you may have hypothermia by the time you get to the other side. Throwing it up the hill, trying to climb up, not a good idea. You've got a bear up there. Toilet paper. Convenient for the moment, but if you've got only four items, you have a river right next to you. a saw. Nobody said anything about the trees next to you. And if it was a huge tree, how are you going to cut it down? You can't climb it to cut small branches because your ankle's broken or maybe broken. Lighter, that'd be great if you had something to burn, like toilet paper, right? You have a first aid kit. You have an emergency blanket that will keep you warm, and it also reflects light so people would be able to see you if they're flying over or walking by you. Have a flashlight. This flashlight has a Morse code.
Okay.
That would give your position away if someone saw it at night. Okay? And you guys were willing to, you were able to touch these things. You have a mosquito net. That might be convenient, or it could be used for catching fish, possibly. Yeah. You have a compass, which I don't think would do you a lot of good because your ankle's broken and you're not going anywhere. You have a hatchet. And if you look closely at that hatchet, you would have also had a striker to be able to start a fire with. Okay.
You didn't
You have duct tape. It could come in handy. You have a water bag that would hold 2 gallons of water. The thing is, you don't really need that because you're next to the river. You can use your hands to scoop up water anytime you want. So to use one of the items to store water like this or a canteen, to me, may not be the best choice of the items you choose. Again, I don't have all the answers, guys. I'm just going through my thought process. You got a glow stick, which would be great so you don't feel lonely. And so the bear can find out where you are. That's helpful. It's a glow stick. This is a hooded poncho to keep you dry. Okay. This is a whistle that you could use if anybody's, a search party's going to be out, right? But remember, you're not where you told your parents you would be because of the mudslide. So if you thought they'd find your car and then they'd find you, not true, because your car's back in town. You took the shuttle and you didn't update your parents as to where you are. Okay, question.
The whistle is a horrible idea.
Really?
Yes.
Have you ever seen Titanic?
What
if the whistle saved them?
No, it's still a horrible idea.
Tell us why.
You're on land, right?
What's that?
You're on land, right?
You're on land?
Animals like coyotes or something. You have to think about that.
Right.
Yeah,
it's true.
And the odds of people finding you from a whistle are slim to none because it's a whistle.
Really?
Yes.
Well, that's a theory. You also had a knife that could have been used to cut things, to skin fish if you got a fish. You've got peanut butter.
Peanut butter.
Right? That's great if you like peanut butter. If you're allergic to it, you're in. Not in good shape.
High protein.
You would be an anaphylactic shock as well as a broken leg, and that would not be good if you're allergic to it. Here was a bracelet that's braided rope that you could use as rope as well. You have a battery, and you have steel wool. If you touch the battery to steel wool, it starts a fire. You could start a fire with that. You have a little notebook. You could write down your last wishes and farewell to your family. All right, that come in handy. You have a flint that you could use to strike with a rock to start fire. You have a cell phone, which has been dead since my son was a teenager, so 15 years. You have a laser pointer, which would be great. Maybe planes could see you, I don't know. Maybe you could point in the bear's eyes and blind them. You've got a stun gun, which might make the bear mad, so that he then eats you. You've got a canteen, but again, you've got water in your hands right there every day, as much as you want. You have dehydrated food. This is high energy, dehydrated. It'll store, it'll keep. I don't know that it tastes very good. You have binoculars, which I don't know what you would do with that. You've got a solar charger for your cell phone. But I don't think you have cell service where you are. I'm sorry. I that would have been nice to know ahead of time, but
that's not even the right charger, is it?
It's a charger for a cell phone? Yeah.
No, but it's not the right charger for that.
Well, no, it's not, but it's not my problem. You've got a magnifying glass.
Start a fire.
Very good. All right. So what would my choice be? I thought about this. I would choose this, right? Because I can stay warm with it, and I can also reflect and get people passing by or planes. It's very, very bright, and it's aluminum shiny, so it'll reflect. The other item I would have chosen was the whistle. The whistle is a brilliant idea.
No, it's a horrible idea.
This is the loudest whistle you can buy, and if anybody's on a search party, they're going to be listening for whistle. No, I'm not going to blow it. No. Then the other thing I would choose probably is the dehydrated food, because I believe there's more energy in this than there is in the peanut butter, and I'm not sure how I'd get that out without a stick. That'd be pretty dirty. What's that? That's three. I'll reveal my last one in just a minute. I think you guys are all dead. It's a bad situation, though. I set you guys up. It's a difficult one. Think about it. Your ankle's broken. You can't move. Maybe crawl, maybe, but how far can you crawl? Right?
Far enough.
Far as you have to, right? Yes.
How cold is the water?
Cold? I said it was cold. How fast does water warm up?
He said you were going to dehydrate.
No, I said you were going to hypothermia.
You're going to get hypothermia. So it's obviously cold enough that if you're exerting all your energy.
How big is the river?
It's a big river. About 10 feet more than that rope.
You can't swim. You can't swim.
Look, guys, I'm teasing with you. You guys, you had reasons for your decisions, and that's good. The decisions I made, they may not have worked out either, right? This is a very difficult situation, and that's important that we understand. My fourth choice would have been the Bible that was sitting there the entire time. None of you guys chose the Bible. That would have been my first choice, right? At my age, that would have been my first choice. I don't want this. Oh, it was on the table the entire time, wasn't it? I said anything on the table. Let me tell you some things about the Bible. The Bible is the best-selling book of all time. No other book has been reproduced anything close to the Bible. 25 million copies are sold each year in the United States alone. 89 million worldwide. It is also the most stolen book in the world. More people steal Bibles than any other book. The full Bible consists of 39 books of the Old Testament and 27 books in the New Testament. It has been translated into 532 languages. Additionally, it's been partially translated into 2,883 languages. The authors of the Bible, more than 40 authors of the Bible, came from different groups of people. Some were kings, some were slaves, fishermen, shepherds, teachers, and even murderers. Some knew each other, but most did not. But amazingly, their words do not contradict each other. And though many authors didn't meet, many of their stories flow in a chronological order. But can you trust it? I'll give you one example. Jesus fulfilled over 300 prophecies that were written in the Old Testament. All of these prophecies were written between 500 and 1,000 years before he was born. The odds of fulfilling just eight prophecies, is this. Suppose you were to take a silver dollar. Anybody know what a silver dollar is?
No.
It's this right here. It's a silver dollar. This one's from 1878, almost 150 years old. If you were to take this silver dollar, come up here, Gabby, if you would, and mark this silver dollar with something that you would be able to recognize anywhere. Doesn't have to be secret. Just whatever you want to put on there so you know the silver dollar that you're going to be looking for.
Oh, gosh.
Be a star.
No, because anybody can draw a star.
No, but this is just for you to recognize. Nobody else has to recognize. Just you.
Oh.
Just you. And it'll be the only one marked. So that should be easy.
Is that actually 150 years old?
Yep.
Why are you?
Just a couple years older than me. I don't know how much it's worth. All right, so let me tell you this story, and this is truth. This is what odds look like. Suppose you take a silver dollar and you take a bunch of them and you lay them across the entire state of Texas. You stack each stack as close as you can, 2 feet high, okay? The entire state, it takes 8 hours to go 100 miles an hour across Texas, 8 hours. You're gonna stack these 2 feet high on every square inch of Texas. Now, you're gonna put a blindfold on and you're gonna get into a helicopter with a parachute. And you're gonna tell the pilot, once they take off, when you would like them to stop. They will stop and they will hover. You will then jump out of the airplane, blindfolded, which I don't recommend, but blindfolded, you will land and you will bend over and dig through as many as you want that you can't see, and you would pick up that silver dollar and say, I am sure this is the one.
The one?
The one that she marked. The odds of you getting this coin 2 feet deep, the entire state of Texas, and finding the right one blindfolded are the odds of Jesus fulfilling just 8 prophecies. 8 prophecies. He fulfilled over 300. That is impossible odds if you add that up. Just doing 8. All right? The Bible being printed. Do you know where most Bibles are printed? Anybody? What country prints the most Bibles? China. China prints the most Bibles. And China, in 2019, they produced 200 million Bibles. They produce 7 Bibles each minute. Now realize that China is the second biggest country in the world. China is the largest communist country in the world, and China is the largest atheist country in the world. I think God has a real sense of humor in how he can use his creation for his glory. So why would I choose the Bible over any of these other items? The Bible reveals God's character and his plan for your life. Right now, you're laying there by the river with a broken ankle. There is no better time to figure out what the plan of life is for you. Why am I here? Why is God allowing this? What's he going to do? And how can I draw closer to him? God is full of patience, love, kindness, justice, wisdom. He's all-knowing and all-creating. He knows you better than anybody knows you. And he knows what's best for you. Another reason is the Bible gives instruction for daily life. The Bible teaches us how to pray. Guess what? This is a good time to be praying with a broken ankle, the bottom of a cliff with a bear above and a river beside you. The Bible explains the truth of God and his son Jesus. It teaches us how to trust God. It shows what God's will is. It also is full of God's promises, not only for others, but for you. It teaches you how to forgive, how to love. It teaches you how to be a good husband or a wife, how to be a good friend, how to be a good parent. It teaches you all kinds of things that you need to know in your life. It's also full of truth and wisdom. I've seen a lot of teenagers in my almost 40 years of doing ministry. And the ones who have kept their eyes on Jesus, even though they will waver a little, they've kept their eyes on Jesus. Their lives are so much better than the ones who take their eyes off of Jesus and go after the things of the world. They become lost. They become empty. They become lonely. And yes, there may be short bursts of enjoyment or pleasure, but it ends up in pain and misery, and I really cannot think of an exception to that in all the years that I've been helping lead young people. So I would choose the Bible for the Bible by itself. But I would also choose this Bible because I have a satellite tracker in the back of this Bible,
what?
Which would have been really helpful in this circumstance.
Hey, that's
set up. I also happen to have in this Bible $200 that could have been used to be able to party with your friends when you got saved. It would have been awesome to have that.
Pay,
or pay the hospital bill. You're right. You're right. That's good thinking. That's an 18-year-old almost thinking right there. I would have chosen the Bible not for this reason, but for all that it contains and how to lead us in our lives. Amen?
Amen.
I love you all. I do. I love you all.
That seemed really unfair.
It was unfair as soon as the $200 comes out, right?
You know, but also the satellite tracker.
Well, you were free to look at any of the items.
You said on top.
We got to keep going, guys. As a congregation, we hunger to follow Jesus and all that he said and all that he did. And when Jesus was on this earth, he spent time with his friends and his family. And one of the things that he instituted was a thing called the Lord's Supper, or the Last Supper. We as a congregation want to do that as well in remembrance of him, because he says, whenever you do this, do it in remembrance of me. So we want to do that. So here at Surrey Hills, we do communion every week. And if this is your first time and you don't feel comfortable doing communion, that's okay. You're free to stay in your seats. But we at Surrey Hills believe everybody is invited to the table of the Lord. Because of what he has done, we are free to go and partake of what he has for us. We don't go because of our goodness, our righteousness, or because we have our acts together, because none of us would go if that is the case. We are all in progress, in process with him and the Holy Spirit working and transforming our hearts and our minds. I do want to say that there's tables on each side, and at those tables there's wine, there is grape juice, there is leavened bread, and there is unleavened crackers. So if you have any allergies or preferences, please read the signs carefully. Let's go ahead and stand up if we could, go back the center aisles, get your communion elements and bring them back, and we'll take it together.
We all start on the outside, the outside looking in. This is where grace begins. We were hungry, we were thirsty, with nothing left to give. Oh, the shape that we were in. And just when all hope seemed lost, love opened the door for us. He said, come to the table. Come join the sinners who have been redeemed. Take your place beside the Savior. Sit down and be set free. Come to the table. And these thieves, there's no one unwelcome here. And that sin and shame that you brought with you, you can leave it at the door and let mercy draw you near. So come
that night when Jesus was betrayed. He took bread and he gave thanks to the Heavenly Father. And Lord, we give thanks as well. And thank you for sustaining us, for giving us life. But we thank you also for Jesus Christ, who is the bread of life. As we take of this bread, let us say, we remember. And then he took the cup and he said, this is the blood of a new covenant poured out for the sins of the world. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son. And as we drink of this, let's remember what Jesus did in his birth, life, death, resurrection, and ascension on our behalf. And that he trades his life for our life if we let him. As we partake of this, let us say we remember. At GC Surrey Hills, we believe that prayer is a vital part of who we are and of worshiping God. So as CJ said it earlier, if you would like to give us a prayer request, you can take one of the connection cards in front of you in the seat back, fill that out, fold it in half, place it in the basket that will be coming around shortly. We also believe that giving is a response of worship to our loving God. He says to come and to give freely. He says to prepare ahead of time what you would like to give. That's scriptural. Doesn't tell you how much. He just says, come prepared to give and come with a cheerful heart. So if you would like to join us in ministry and sharing the good news, you can also place a check or envelope that you have in the seat back in front of you in the basket as it comes around. There are other ways to join us in giving as well. You can give on our website online, or you can do the envelope in the basket, or you can give by text. No gift is too large, and no gift is too small. I love you all. Have a great week.
All right. As those baskets are going around, we do have just a couple of announcements to go over. First thing, we have Baptism Sunday next Sunday. We are so excited. We're going to have baptisms. We have a couple of baby dedications, but we need your help with the next part. We are going to celebrate together as a church, and we are going to have a church potluck. So if you would please bring a dish to share, we are going to celebrate together with good food and amazing friendships. That'll be right after church next Sunday on the 14th. And then what's our next announcement, Kaysen? Is it on?
Yeah. Our second announcement is food truck night. Food truck night is every Thursday from 5:30 to 7:30. And bring friends. If you don't bring friends, you'll still have lots of food and have lots of fun.
Yes, it's a great time. So be sure to come out for food truck night every single Thursday. All right, I think we're ready to close out in worship.
If you would please stand and join us as we just continue to celebrate Jesus this morning. Worship you with our whole hearts this morning. We give you everything that we have. We thank you for all that you've done, all that you're doing, and all that you're going to do. We place our faith, our hope, and our trust in you.
Our God, a firm foundation, our rock, the only solid ground. Nations rise and fall. Kingdoms once strong, now shaken. We trust forever in your name, the name of Jesus.
Almighty God, we lift you high.
Because you are the only King forever. Almighty God, we lift you higher. You are the only King forever. Forevermore, you are victorious.
Ah, oh, he's unmatched.
Unmatched in all your wisdom, in love and justice you will reign, and every knee will bow. Our hope is anchored in your name of Jesus.
Who do we trust?
We trust the name of Jesus. You are the only King forever. Almighty God, we lift you higher. You are the only King forever. Forevermore. You are victorious, you are the only King forever. Almighty God, we lift you higher. You are the only King forever. Forevermore, you are victorious.
All right, we're going to lift our banners high. And this morning, our banners are going to be our hands and our voices. All right, here we go.
God, we lift you higher. You are the only King forever. Forevermore, you are victorious. You are the only King forever. Almighty God, we lift you higher. You are the only King forever. Forevermore, you are victorious.
First up, if you have a connection card in the seat in front of you and you've never filled out one before, fill that sucker out, take it to our Connection Corner desk, and you can get yourself a free Jesus period t-shirt.
You guys know what I'm going to say. Don't forget your kids. We love them, but we can't keep them.
Don't forget those kids. We love you guys so much. We can't wait to see you next week. But until then, remember
you are loved.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.